a warm virtual welcome, Dr. Sunil, and I will hand over to you.
Okay. First of all, today I'll be covering the significance of modeling in the era of digital transformation, especially with the digital connected world, with social media being part of our lifestyle. The human brain has been rewired. We prefer to have a bite-sized information versus voluminous documentation. And we want rich information. And it must be very visual and it must make some sense. So in that context, let me introduce like why modeling is a significant success factor for a digital transformation. Steve already has introduced about me, so I'll not go through it. Disclaimer is a company policy. We try to keep the information as relevant as possible. At the same time, the digital world, we don't have the control. Okay, just to come to my next slide. So today we're covering basically about what is the drivers, which is really enabling modeling as a key concept. Then I'll be talking about, I take a case study. From the case study perspective, I'm going to introduce why the transformation, why we need a modeling aspect. And from there, why Archimedes is a de facto modeling language in the world at this moment, and how a tool can complement for success. Sorry. Okay. See, digital transformation started the moment an organization start using any kind of a machinery for the business perspective. So said that the moment a company used technology as a landline or a typewriter, moving forward, we have the computers. So said that digital transformation is a continuous process. Organizations will be using technology as it emerges to give a better service, to reduce the operational cost, to give a better service to the customers. And especially with the digital world, any services they provide must be accessible by a handheld device. So again, this is pre-COVID. So post-COVID, companies realized is not only giving the services for the customers on any device, even the services we are offering must be able to be manageable remotely by the staff at the comfort of the home. This brought in its own market forces, that is the compliance that is required. Ideally, a staff was in a secure environment, but once the staff is working remotely, the two accessing some of the sensitive data of the company, is a compliance issue. Again, security, before the customer was sitting at the comfort of an office with a secure network, but working from the home, it brought in its own security risk. Then coming back to the evolving technology, technology keeps on evolving. Unless, until we abstract the technology capability with the actual technology, it's not possible to have a proper message or proper way of implementing. I'm getting it. Okay. Now let us look at what is the global village. My slides be? Sorry. Okay. Then look at let us look at what is the global village. Due to COVID, global virtual village is realized. So said that the staff are working remotely across the world, with they're not traveling and communicating across. Just to look at the welcome message, if you look at the different various languages, it's hardly hard to understand. At the same time, if you have some kind of a standard notation, it's very easy to understand. And looking at the model, a picture worth a thousand words, and especially with technology becoming a commodity, systems are becoming more complex. So unless until we give some kind of visual representation, it's not able to make real understanding of what is the outcome or what is expected for the customer. Looking at the digital transformation, 85% of the transformation project space. One of the studies from PMI is mainly because of the communication. Again, from the APMG study in 2017, 65% failed. Looking at the commonality, one of the key things is communication between customers, developers, and the business. So what's happening is the information is lost. There is a communication gap. Up to the team spread across the globe, is much more complicated, and systems are becoming more complex, is not able to comprehend with the current practice of documentation based, and users are not able to comprehend the requirements because various companies follow various practices. There's no standard way of capturing the user information. And again, poor reporting is one of the costs. Let us look at what are the drivers for which is driving the standard modeling. Global outsourcing in 2019 was $92 billion. That is pre-COVID. With COVID, this will accelerate further in the coming years. Because once companies realize they can able to get the work done remotely, so that the next phase they're looking at, why can't we offshore or outsource? So it becomes more complicated to have a modeling practice. Typical systems in a company is about 500. But as it becomes more as a service as a model, everything a service as a model, it'd be much more complicated. Then worldwide spending in the cloud is $227 billion. With again with COVID, it will be further accelerated. And companies moving their technical debt from their on-prem to cloud, they need to have a standard notation to abstract the information. Again, software development has completely changed. What was like 5 or 10 languages, now we've got some 30, 40 standard languages across the enterprise, which need to be addressed such a way that it can be comprehended by the people across the world. Of course, I covered about working remotely and office space in my earlier slide. Let us take a bank case study. From there, I'll introduce why the modeling is essential. At the same time, why Archimate becomes a de facto modeling language. This is one of the opportunity we got. The company wanted to go to cloud. They already started a journey long back. And especially with the current scenario, looking at what's happening in the world, they want to really downsize the application, reduce the number of applications. At the same time, to move into the cloud, for 60% of the workload. So then we looked at the current landscape, what the company was having. The company was having the current legacy system as well as the modern applications, what was possible in the cloud. So already they had a spaghetti, they had one more spaghetti. They had an enterprise active practice, but unfortunately the enterprise active practice, there was this all documentation based. I'll be explaining in my next. The current documentation was voluminous because companies generally have enterprise architecture practices, but generally they don't follow a tool or standard notation. Then afterwards, information was spread across multiple documentation done by different team members. At the same time, they were using different modeling language. And if you go to any enterprise, and which I have come across, even in this, typically in this customer also, whichever the standard modeling language, again, using Visio, it is the creativity of the user to come out with innovative look and feel so the customers can, the business customers can be happy. So there's no standard convention. And it was not possible to get a holistic view of the end result from. Then looking at the next scenario of offshoring, of course, every company nowadays, they have an offshore team or outsource team. So they had a language barrier and every company follow the concept of agile and they don't produce enough documentation. And again, the staff working remotely or the outsourcing company, they don't have access to all the documentation. And again, if the user want to get a concept of what is end-to-end, they need to be able to know multiple notations. And they're not able to get a single view of what is expected. Then we're able to convince the customer, you must go for Archimate more as a standard to go across. Then let me explain what is Archimate. Some of you already know that. Archimate is a visual language. Again, it's got a standard iconography. So it can be able to describe and analyze and communicate across the enterprise from business all the way to the implementation. Again, address the concerns of the enterprise holistically. The TOGAF is a specification of 532 pages, where Archimate is a 200-page specification, which can be able to model whatever the specification of TOGAF we give to the customer can be modeled and represented. Again, Archimate is keeps aligned with the time. So you can able to even changing a documentation versus a model is much more easier to manage. The customers still were not in a position to take our offering. So then we had some few workshops with various, we made various groups. So when we made with the first group for the business, then we told the business, see, there's only like few artifacts or few notations you need to understand. And again, any business, you have a stakeholder, there are some functions, there are some processes. So we explain, we show the notation. So once you understand this concept, easy to communicate, there's no ambiguity. The customers were happy for that. Then we had some sessions with the technical team. Then finally, what we told them is, see, this is following a concept of a standard language, as in English. As a subject, what an enterprise can able to perform is in work. And again, what you perform, it generates a data which is required across the enterprise, right from the strategy to the implementation. So the customer is able to understand the Archimate, at least the concept of it. So once we're able to convince the business as well as the technical team, then they told, yes, we can go for this, it's fine. Then again, the next hurdle, what we faced was how to go for a tool. So then we proposed a model, right from strategy to the technology architecture, how everything can be tracked. And again, we bifurcated the core architecture as well as the supporting architecture with the cross-cutting as project management and service, a separate layer. Then the next obstacle started for us. So why do we want to go for an Archimate? Is there any other? Why there's no other standard? Then we told, yes, because Archimate is the only standard which is backed by the open group. Again, it's keep aligned with the change of the technology. It's an unambiguous language. Again, very important thing is able to visualize almost 80% of the use cases in enterprise. Again, it's the only language where business and IT can able to talk to each other because they're following a common convention. And the good news is absolutely free. So the customer were really enticed. Then we had the next obstacle. Is it everything is fine, but they're not ready to invest on a tool. The problem, what was happening is, generally in enterprises, they use Visio as a modeling tool. And they generate the Visio, we are using Visio template, the Archimate notations. So then we told, it's humanly impossible to have without a tool to go for such a major transformation. Then afterwards, we told them the benefit of a tool. With a tool, it is possible to visualize an enterprise asset. Not only the current view, the future, what's going to happen, something like a 720-degree view of the enterprise. Then again, we convinced them it's going to ensure a consistency across the enterprise. It's going to give a collaborative environment between the enterprises. At the same time, business comes with new innovative ideas. With a tool in place, it is possible to have a standard simulation where the business can able to see what is the outcome. And especially with digital transformation, as I'm listening to our previous speakers, we're getting 4G, 5G, IoT, so much of technology is coming in. So one of the key things is, though companies are taking a digital transformation journey, at the same time, the way the technology is evolving, they need to change the technology strategy. Nowhere any company can have a strategy which is built in for 4 or 5 years, not even 6 months, the way the technology is changing. Especially with COVID, what we have seen is, whatever the digital strategy a company had, everything must be revisited and revised and updated. So said that, the roadmap, what we do, only with a tool, it is possible to see what is the impact, what is the outcome of it. It's going to help us to make a better decision making. At the same time, to see what kind of technology suits the company. Then, one of the advantage of Archimate, what Archimate gives is reusability. So the reusability can be ensured having a tool which makes a consistency as well as the assets can be tracked back. One of the key things with enterprise architect practice, though it is sometimes in a company is in a dormant nature, and sometimes if the company is matured, it is in a very commanding nature. But unfortunately, what happens, companies have a EA practice, but without a standard notation and without a tool, it gives a false illusion they're following EA practice, but they're not getting the end result, what is expected from an EA. And it was good, especially when the companies were going with a CapEx model, where the technology, where the product lifecycle was 10 to 20 years, especially with cloud and everything a service model, is very essential, critical to have the enterprise modeled across end to end, and whatever possible assets need to be persisted in an EA tool, of course, following the standard notation of Archimate, such a way everything is visible. At the same time, whatever the KPIs which we identify, right from the strategy to all the way to implementation, it can be traced with Archimate, which gives a notation right from the strategy to all the way to the implementation. At the same time, with the tool, is going to make the provision much more easier. And one of the important things of EA was, without Archimate, a typical enterprise, a consultancy, if you go, we're producing about 100, 200 pages of documentation. With EA tool, everything can be visualized and able to engage the customer to get a clear picture of what is expected. Then looking at the tool, sorry guys, there's one picture I missed it out. Okay, sorry. Then we looked at the rationale of the tool. As you can see from the picture here, let us take an example of COVID now. When you look at the COVID, what's happening is, if you want to represent the same diagram with a documentation, here what is shown is, it's a board. The board one, the driver is COVID. They look at one of the drivers is staff working remotely. Again, it's a positive and a negative. Initially, it is a negative because the company did not have the capability to work remotely. Then if you make an assessment, one is the regulatory compliance because the staff are working from the home. Then looking at one more assessment, it can be a security breach. How to make an assessment for that? Then again, the next one is like the company got to investigate. Oh, my staff is working remotely. Why can't we offshore outsource? Then again, they're going to look at the constraints. What are the regulatory requirements? Again, you can see the symbol here. It's an outcome. So then they realize, oh, post-COVID, we can able to reduce the human dependency. Why can't we go for RPA? We'll be having less dependency on human and more of automation. So a picture worth 1,000 words, as you can see here. If the same thing need to be done, it takes a multiple documentation, goes across the team. If you have a documentation, a proper notation, you can able to assemble the stakeholders in one room and able to get the thing sorted out in a much shorter time. Just coming back to my last slide. So then again, the customer asked, which tool should we procure? There's so many tools in the industry. So we told them better to go for a tool which is certified by the Open Group. Again, go with the version which is the latest because that's where which supports all the notations, what is required for an enterprise. Then, of course, I cannot tell the tool which we qualified. At the same time, if you want to start with something, there's open source tool, Archie. They can try to utilize it. They're able to get the output, at least to convince the customer what is expected. The summary of today is the key takeaway. Digital transformation is a continuous process. It will be ever evolving. At the same time, to manage this transformation, you need to have some kind of a standard tooling practice. And especially with outsourcing and cloud becoming a key enabler, the teams will be spread across the world. So with that, unless until you have a standard tool backed up by Open Group, which is Archimate, and that complemented with a tool can increase the success rate of digital transformation. So I hope I kept my time. I'm just watching my time and went with it. So please, any questions, you can type me out. I'm going to answer it once the question and answer.
Sunil, you've done a wonderful job. Thank you, and delivered a wonderful advertisement for Archimate, which is always music to my ears. So thank you.